So, refreshing ARM architecture, if you observe this carefully, there are two types of architecture normally we need to understand. One thing what you need to understand is there is something like micro architecture, and there is other architecture is called as instruction set architecture. People used to say ISA, instruction set architecture. So those micro architectures, this semester you are studying FPGA, no? Micro architectures are meant for VLSI design engineers, chip design engineers, etc. Instruction set architectures are mainly available for the users. So this diagram is much familiar diagram to all of us, where the ARM architecture starts from ARM7 TDMI. ARM architecture starts from ARM7 TDMI in the bottom left corner, and then ARM9, then ARM11. So ARM starts with 7, 9 and 11, which was the classical ARM process which was used long back. After that, ARM processor manufacturers have decided to manufacture the processor architecture specific to the particular applications. So they have named it as ARM Cortex series. Okay. So they are broadly differentiating into ARM classical ARM processors and ARM Cortex processors. So in ARM Cortex processor, again we have ARM, ARM, application processors, real-time processors and microcontroller processors. So these application processors sit inside the Qualcomm Snapdragon, used in mobile applications and all multimedia applications, CCTV camera, IP camera, television receivers, wherever we have a multimedia, right? Camera, wherever we have a display, wherever we have audio, wherever we have video, wherever there is a battery operated applications, there we use ARM Cortex A series of application, which is application series application, starts from Cortex A5, A7, A8, A9. It goes up to ARM Cortex A73. And it is meant for application with more memory management unit and which supports the mobile OS kind of things. And another thing, which is real-time Cortex processors, which is meant for safety critical applications. Okay, so when we talk about anti-lock braking system, ABS, when we talk about airbag systems, when we talk about security systems, there Cortex R series are widely used, which is called as real-time processor cores, as you see in the yellow color, R4, R5, R7, R8 and R52. And another microcontroller, they are all Cortex M series. That means the Cortex M processors are meant for microcontrollers. So all the microcontrollers mostly will have Cortex M series of processor in it, which is dedicated for developing embedded applications as well as Internet of Things applications. So characteristics of ARM Cortex processors, if you see the design, right? In the first column, we talk about application processors, Cortex A series processors. In the second column, we talk about real-time processors. In the third column, we talk about microcontroller processors. That means ARM Cortex M series for microcontroller manufacturers, R series for real-time microcontrollers, A series for application series processors. So here, if we talk about design, high clock frequency means, so normally when we talk about 8051, we talk about 12 megahertz. Here we talk about at least close to 1 gigahertz, similar to our Intel Core i7 kind of things. So it works with very high frequency, maximum up to 1 gigahertz of frequency. So please think of where is 12 megahertz and where is 1 gigahertz. So very high frequency, that is why high clock frequency is your application process in the first column. So very long pipeline, say for example 6-stage pipelining. Okay, pipelining enhances the speed, so we go for 6-stage pipelining in this application process series, and obviously high performance, and it is supporting multimedia, so wherever there is audio and video, definitely it supports. So Neon instruction set extension, especially designed for multimedia applications. So this is the design and the features. What are the features? Memory management unit, right? So our Windows operating systems has memory management unit, right? What is the significance of memory management unit? So let's say our processor is a 32-bit processor. So 2 power 32 is 4 GB. So 4 GB memory space can be accessed directly from the Intel Core i7 processors, where the random access memory of 4 GB, say for example, that is called as main memory. So the memory which can be accessed directly by the processor is called as main memory. The hard disk is the secondary memory. Exchanging of data between the main memory and secondary memory will be taken care by memory management unit. Because of the presence of memory management unit, there is a possibility for us to access the entire 1 terabytes of hard disk just because of memory management unit. So very large space. Why? Because when you take any audio, when we take any video, that too high definition audio and video means it occupies more space, and the memory management unit is mandatory for any multimedia applications. Hence, MMU plays a major role in Cortex A series applications. And obviously, there should be a cache memory, which is very high speed memory, which can be used very much. And ARM Trust Zone security extension. And normally, we talk about tamper proof security. Today, security is playing a major role. No? So, Trust Zone, there is something like ARM Trust Zone, which is a trademark of ARM, where the security is also ensured with respect to ARM Cortex A series of processors. These are all the system features with respect to ARM Cortex A series. Okay. With this design, with this system features, what is the target application? Mobile computing, smartphones, energy efficient servers, and high-end microprocessors. So wherever you can see the audio and video, obviously, definitely, there exists ARM Cortex A series processor core sitting inside. Similarly, when you come to the real-time processors, that is also using high clock frequency and long to medium pipeline length. Long to medium pipelining means normally 3-stage, 4-stage pipelining, and deterministic, row interrupt latency. Deterministic means what? We are able to predict exactly when the interrupt service routine will get executed. That is called deterministic, right? So whenever we talk about deterministic with respect to microcontrollers, we talk about interrupt latency. So even Windows itself is not deterministic, you must know. Okay, I'll tell you an example. When you click MS Word file, we cannot exactly determine within 1 second MS Word file will open. Based on the memory management unit, based on the other space available in the random access memory, DDR RAM and the hard disk, it will take either 2 seconds or it will take either 2 milliseconds or it may take any even 2 minutes based on the system, based on the memory management unit. So that is why it is not deterministic. Even though it is a Windows operating system, we cannot determine moment I click within 1 millisecond the MS Word file will open, or within five seconds MS Word will file open. Exactly, we cannot say. Hence, even Windows itself is not deterministic. But name itself justifies it as real-time processors. Hence, we can able to determine, okay, whenever the break is applied, automatically ABS system, anti-lock braking system will apply once in 100 millisecond means. Once in 100 millisecond, ABS has to function. If there is any delay, like when I press the MS Word file and it will take 5 seconds, if you are not able to determine means, we cannot able to reduce the stopping distance of a car, and the ABS system may not be, performance of the ABS system may not be ensured. Hence, real-time processors, deterministic nature is very important. For our desktop systems and our laptops, deterministic is not mandatory. Even we can tolerate 5 second delay or 10 second delay. That is why the OS is designed like that. Okay, so one very interesting thing that you have to observe is deterministic means we can able to predict, okay, within 5 seconds this will happen, within 2 seconds this will happen, which is not possible even in Windows with that example of MS Word file opening kind of things. Okay, so deterministic low interrupt latency is the very interesting word that you have to understand. And in multimedia applications, there is a need for memory management unit because there is a large amount of audio and video signals which has to be exchanged between hard disk and random access memory. But in terms of real-time process, you are going to switch on a motor, we are going to switch off a motor, you are going to switch on an actuator, you are going to switch off an actuator. The RAM size should be very less and the program size should be more. And there is no multimedia is involved here. Hence, but because real-time process have to ensure the security, so there should be a memory protection unit. What is the use of memory protection unit? There are different levels of protections. Say for example, user can access only this memory space. We can segment the addressable memory into different hierarchies. Okay, so user can access only this memory space, and the admin can access only this memory space, etc. That can be configured, and if the user goes beyond that memory space, means an exception interrupt will be generated, and it will notify the processor. This is to prevent the damage of the code, or the it will ensure the safety and security of the code, as well as it will ensure the safety and security of the application. Hence, memory protection unit MPU is mandatory for such kind of real-time processors. Hence, that is available as a mandatory module, like memory management unit in an application module. And similarly, there exists a cache memory, and there is something like tightly coupled memory. Why? Because it has to execute in high speed to make it as deterministic. That's very interesting. Okay, so with this memory protection unit with the deterministic design, the target market is industrial microcontrollers, automotives, hard disk controllers, baseband modem. So you must know that there is a hard disk drive. This hard disk drive is controlled by real-time processors like ARM Cortex R series of microcontrollers, which controls the spinning motor of the hard disk, as well as the head motor of the hard disk. So moment we click some particular folder, immediately the content will be read from that particular location, and then it is coming to the random access memory, and then it is displayed in the screen. So high speed control and high precision control with very minimum latency is mandatory. Hence, most of the hard disk uses ARM Cortex R series of microcontrollers, where even in 1 TB space, just like that, in single click you are able to read the data from the corresponding location. So it has to rotate in that much aligned way, and it has to read in the corresponding location in a proper way. It's very complex but very interesting, right? And then automotives means obviously definitely ABS, anti-lock braking system, electronic stability programs, adaptive cruise controls, and hill hold, and lot more automotive applications. Definitely the real-time processors are most widely used in the ECUs of those microcontrollers, those applications. And industrial microcontrollers, where we are using pick and place robots, most of the robots uses microcontrollers, means it's mostly it is going to be real-time microcontrollers. And the last column talks about microcontroller process, which is there in our syllabus. Okay, so we are using this microcontroller process. What is the design facility? Uses usually shorter pipeline, the last column, usually shorter pipeline, ultra low power, uses very low power, and it is deterministic, no interrupt latency. So very low power is the prime requirement. Why? Because in your car, right, if you are having keyless entry, right, you're having keyless entry now, whenever you press a button, click, something like that, the central locking system, keyless entry, remote keyless entry, they uses some kind of microcontroller, Cortex M series of process, because most of the time it sleeps. That's why the keyless entry, no need to change the battery for a long duration of time. But it is wireless, it has to cover approximately some 500 meter range. So whenever there is a wireless, lot of energy is mandatory, but more optimally it is designed in such a way that the keyless entry remote in our hand is going to withstand for several months, just because of ultra low power nature of ARM Cortex M series of microprocessors. Okay, so that is the design benefit. And what are the system features? As discussed in real-time process, here also we have memory protection unit, and there is something like nested vectored interrupt controllers. We know what is interrupt, we have discussed a lot about it, and those interrupts are nested, and they are all vectored interrupt. Hence it is called as nested vectored interrupt controller. If time permits, we will be discussing about that in detail. Okay, so the interrupts are the features of ARM Cortex M series. So microcontroller peripherals can provide the interrupt, so the interrupts will be handled properly with the help of ARM Cortex M series of processors, because all the applications, right, as discussed several times, every input is an interrupt, right? Every input is an interrupt in our day-to-day life, right? Okay, so the nested vector interrupt controllers are very much useful in responding to the interrupt, highest priority interrupt, properly. So normally zero waiting state for highest priority task, something like that, there is one statement. So whenever there is a highest priority task, so the waiting time is zero, immediately it will get responded. So because of nested vector interrupt controller, so dynamic priority scheduling and lot more facilities are available. We'll be discussing about that in detail. And there is something like wake up interrupt controller. So normally it will go to sleep to save more power, like power down mode and idle mode in 8051. Here there are a lot of sleep modes. Most of the time, if there is no work, it will go and sleep. So whenever there is a need comes, there is something like wake up interrupt controller, which will wake up the crystal oscillator and processor and the memory and the peripherals, and it will start functioning within few microseconds. That intelligence is there. Why? To save more power whenever not in use. Okay. So for example, when you talk about keyless entry, right, in your car, right? By the time of opening the door and closing the door only, we are using that buttons. Rest of the time, we are inserting the key. It is idle, right? In a day, mostly we may not use that feature, right? But most of the time, it has to sleep. Whenever we are taking the car, we are taking the keyless entry, we are pressing that button. By the time we press the button, wake up interrupt controller will switch on the crystal oscillator, processor, peripheral, and it will, or a antenna, then it will transmit the data. The rest of the day, it will go and sleep. And safety for your car is mandatory. If I switch on my button, the nearby car door should not unlock. So safety and security is also very important. That's why ARM Trust Zone security extension in the latest designs with respect to ARM Cortex M series of processor core. And the target market, if you talk about target market, if you see, designed for microcontrollers and mostly for embedded systems, where micro electromechanical systems and mixed signal integrated circuits and Internet of Things. So the third column and third row is our target. So this is some simple overview.